about regionalism and Adam Paul, mayor of Ellisville, and a bit of a controversy. Tony Messenger, St. Louis Post-Dispatch columnist. Good morning.
Good morning, McGraw. Good morning, Kelly. How's everybody doing?
We're doing good. Did you hear Adam Paul yesterday?
I did not get a chance to hear Adam Paul, but I've been tweeting back and forth at the mayor, and so I understand what his position is. And I'm, you know, that's what I'm here for, McGraw. I'm here to make sure that you have guests every day.
If you two just have lunch together, you can cut me out of the whole situation here. So among the things he said yesterday, and he was quite emphatic, saying that if he would encourage the Ellisville residents to join the city of St. Louis the same way he would encourage Ellisville residents, excuse me, to visit a Tijuana prostitute without protection. Pretty strong words. Clearly, the man does not want to join and have anything to do with the city of St. Louis.
Well, and here's what Mayor Paul doesn't quite understand or doesn't want to allow himself to understand, because he's a pretty smart guy. He can understand some of this stuff if he actually tries to intellectualize it. Look, I, like Mayor Paul, I'll start with some common ground. I agree that I don't trust or agree with all of the motivations of Rex Sinfield, the billionaire financier behind Better Together, and some of the other wealthy folks who are involved in this. He's right. They have some different motives. Mr. Sinfield wants to get rid of the earnings tax. I disagree with him on that. One of Mr. Paul's, Mayor Paul's suggestions is that all of these wealthy folks are afraid that the city of St. Louis is going to go bankrupt and they just want to protect their muni bonds. That may be, there may be some truth to that, but that doesn't address the issue. If St. Louis goes bankrupt, it's bad for Ellisville. It's bad for Wildwood. Because here's what happens. I live a rock's throw from Ellisville. I eat with my family at Ellisville restaurants two, three times a week, because that's right next to Wildwood, and to me, the boundaries don't matter. But my neighbor, who works at the NGA, loses his job when the city of St. Louis goes bankrupt. My neighbor, who works for one of the big hospitals in the city, loses their job. Their house goes down in value. They put their house up for sale or for rent. Our value in the greater St. Louis area, all over the greater St. Louis area, is directly affected by what happens in the city of St. Louis. We aren't here if it isn't for the city of St. Louis. That's just fact. Our economic reality is tied to the city of St. Louis. That is fact. So if your position is you hate the way that city is run, you think there's problems in that city, then you ought to be on board with a solution that fixes the city of St. Louis. And by the way, there's plenty of problems in St. Louis County as well. The fact is we are divided by geography, by race, and that hurts all of us economically. So we ought to be looking for a solution. The mayor is right. Some of the motivations of some of the people pushing consolidation or merger are different than mine. But we share a common philosophy that we want the St. Louis region to be stronger economically. And every fact and every study says that we are weaker economically because of how divided we are by geography, by political boundary, by race.
Tony, speak for a moment, because not only Adam Paul, but a couple of phone calls yesterday were very concerned about taking on the debt responsibilities of the city. And their philosophy is, why should Ellisville, why should Chesterfield be responsible for the debt of the city of St. Louis, and we are just taking on their debt? That doesn't make any sense. We understand we might have to do that, but what's the benefit to Chesterfield by doing something like that?
We are already responsible to some degree for that debt. We drive, those of us who work downtown, we drive on the roads in that city every day. We are protected all day long. When I'm at work, I am protected by the police department that has the pension that some people are claiming is out of control in terms of the debt. I am protected by the fire department of the city St. Louis, all day long while I'm at work. Many of my neighbors work in that city or go to Cardinals games or Blues games in that city or would have liked to go to MLS soccer games in that city. The fact is we are directly connected to that city all the time. The deaths of the city of St. Louis drag all of us down as it exists right now. So why not look for a solution that helps build all of us up? Here's the reality. Look at the budgets of the 89 municipalities in St. Louis County. Guess what? They're not great. And they're dragging us down, too, because what are all those municipalities doing all the time? They're going for different tax hikes and because they can't afford to pay their bills.
Well, the other thing... Go ahead.
This is a problem in the entire region. It's not. It's easy to just pick on the city of St. Louis because it's big. But the fact is, if we combine, we improve our tax situation for everybody because a lot of the taxes we're paying in Ellisville, in Wildwood, in Chesterfield, etc., might go down if all of a sudden we're combining our buying power as one big city.
I will say this, that when you talk about this, the social service aspects of this never really gets taken into account. Ellisville, Chesterfield, St. Charles, Clayton, whatever, they have homeless people, but they don't live in Clayton or St. Charles. They go down to the city of St. Louis, right?
We're already putting our burdens on the city in terms of dealing with homelessness, in terms of dealing with crime, in terms of dealing with economic development.
Right. Yeah, no, whether it's crime, whether it's drug addiction, whether it's whatever, yes, there are drug problems in the other parts of the region, but many of those people go into the city and it's straining the social services and they're taking care of the residents of the region while only being paid for by the residents of the city of St. Louis.
What Mayor Paul can't tell you and what Mayor Paul won't tell you and what no individual mayor in any municipality in St. Louis can tell you is why their city existing as it is today makes the entire region better. There is absolutely no argument for, well, Ellisville has to continue to exist because if not for Ellisville, X, Y, or Z is going to happen in our region. There is not a single argument to be made for that. There are tremendous arguments to be made for the city of St. Louis and St. Louis County to become one again like we were back in the 1870s.
All right, we'll leave it there. Until the next time you want to rile them up again, Tony Messenger. St. Louis Post-Dispatch.
Good to talk to you.
St. Louis Post-Dispatch columnist. Thanks, Tony.